supported the show. All my Storm champions. Move my laptop. That. Let's see. Let me try opening my window to. Okay, yeah, big thank you to my Storm champions at home, my Twitch fam, for mindfulness. Today we'll be revisiting Breed, the mindfulness special. Yeah, it's going to be important, not just for me, but perhaps for some of you. Personally, for me, these are some turbulent times. I'm experiencing a lot of change. And with that can come stress. Like, I'm spending a lot of time thinking about my life's direction, where I'm going next. And considering different things. Trying to stay balanced. And the things that I try, the things that I do, trying to spend equal time reading each day, writing each day, trying new things, playing piano, making progress on different games, and taking time to enjoy the summer, all these things. Things that are on my mind. Okay. Today we'll be taking a look at Quick to Judge. It's all too easy to make snap assessments. But often they reveal more about you than the other person. Let go of judgment, and you might take hold of a whole new world. Are you a judgmental person? Do you find yourself thinking negative thoughts or gossiping about others? Many dictionaries define judgment as the ability to make considered decisions or come to sensible conclusions. But it's also explained as an opinion or a conclusion. And this is where many judgments miss the mark. So you may think that you're doing the former and being considered, but if you look just that little more closely, a lot of the thoughts that flit constantly across your mind are your opinion. A quick fix. Judgment is like fast food. Making a negative appraisal about another person is like a quick fix that makes you feel better. You look at a person society perceives to be overweight eating chocolate and feel better about your own size. Or you think negatively about a colleague who spends time on Facebook and convince herself that you're a far more diligent employee. But what's really going on when you leap to these conclusions? Speaking from experience, I've had times where I've been judgmental about others. Someone like didn't attend a meeting, or was, you know, unnecessarily, in my opinion, quarrelsome. But I think it goes back to perspective, too. I personally try to use judgment as a tool for helping others. Like, I try to think about it less like harsh criticism and more like constructive criticism. Like, I try to channel my feedback that I give others as try to focus on the positive as much as possible. Because there's a lot of things that people are doing that oftentimes are overlooked. Gabriel Bernstein is an author, speaker, and self-proclaimed spirit junkie. In her book, Judgment Detox, she reveals how judgment says more about you than the person you're judging, and that it's sometimes because they reopen deep wounds. For example, a friend has a successful job and you criticize her for not spending enough time with her family. The reality might be that she's juggling the situation as best she can, and she thinks deeply about how to ensure she balances work with family life. Sometimes it's just hard juggling those different priorities. It could be that your assessment comes from personal insecurity about your career achievements. Trying to make continued progress and growth in your career at the sacrifice of other areas of your life. The reasons for making such assessments can have long, deep roots into the past. A lot of it can be based on personal insecurity or sense of security. And job security is one of those things. It's like somewhat inverse to what the author is referring to here. Someone who had weight concerns as a child may think badly of others they consider to be chubby, while a person who was constantly chastised in childhood for being lazy might externalize this in their perception of a colleague as work shy because they scan Facebook every couple of hours. It's like we see the world through our own lens, through the scope and lens of our own experiences. I think I spoke yesterday about how we are the only person who has experienced the things that we've experienced. We're the only person in the history of this planet that has seen the things that we've seen. And in turn, that gives us a unique perspective. That gives us a different way of seeing things and approaching different situations. People respond in different ways to the same thing. There may be some commonalities, but like those different experiences can help to explain the different reactions that some people have to different things. Judgment is used as a defense mechanism. Gabriel insists. I would say sometimes, although that's not always the case. Sometimes you may say critical things to get back someone that you think has wronged you. It's like, oh well, you know, you said I did this wrong, but are you clear of your own blame? Are you clear of your own wrongdoing? Another person triggers your stuff and the response is like a band-aid placed on the wound. This helps you feel better in the moment without looking at what's actually going on beneath the surface. Like an argument, either way, that this can often play out. Everyone does it. Challenges and difficulties encountered in childhood can make people feel vulnerable, and there isn't always a safe space to explore and heal wounds when we reach adulthood. When I read Judgment Detox, I was shocked. I like to think of myself as an empathetic human being who can see the good in everyone. I started, however, to notice my judgments and saw that they were almost like an involuntary reflex. They happened quickly before I could stop them. I think it depends a lot on what the judgment is, too. Some judgments are snap judgments. It's like judgments about the way a person looks, what they're wearing, their overall demeanor and disposition for that day. It was like I was constantly trying to make myself feel better by assessing people on the street, acquaintances, or even friends and loved ones. I judged the woman who was too self-absorbed to think to hold the door open for me as I followed her into a store. The boy walking up the middle of the street staring at his phone and not looking where he was going. The acquaintance who talked about herself all the time and never asked how I was doing. Judgment is the number one reason we feel blocked, sad, and alone. And I think a lot of this plays back, like I said, not just into perspective, but empathy, as it's called. Like trying to put yourself in the other person's shoes. Try to understand what the other person is thinking about, what the other person feels. I oftentimes think that the things that someone does in the moment are a reflection in some way about the things that they're currently experiencing. The woman's not holding the door, for example, I think that it would be the case that she is more preoccupied on where she's going, or what she's looking for, than being courteous at the time. But there are different concerns, too. Like just because someone is not holding the door doesn't necessarily mean they're doing it to be rude. It could just be the case that they're preoccupied, they're busy, their mind is focused on something else. Okay, let's take a look at the picture. There are several people on the far left page. There's a guy, and all these people are walking on what appears to be chart paper. It's a blue page with grid-like lines across. There's a guy on the far left. He is standing by several plants, green leafy plants. And by his head, there's a dotted line of red hearts. The dotted line with hearts, is connecting him to other people. There's another guy next to him that this interlocking line connects. The first guy's got a blue shirt with the moon on it. It's a crescent form. He's wearing black pants. The guy that he's connected to is wearing a brown shirt with the light bulb on it, like a ta-da moment. He's got black pants on. There's a woman that they're both connected to this line. She's wearing a pink dress with several sun-looking shapes on her dress. There's another woman with a longer dress. It is green with stars on it. All four of these people are connected to three others. One guy wearing a pink sweatshirt with sun shape designs on it. He's wearing short yellow shorts. He's got a small watch on his left wrist. It could also be an exercise band or something that he's using to monitor his health. That might be more plausible now that we're in the age of smartphones. There is a woman. She has a beautiful red dress on. It's got yellow and green and orange. Waves. It seems that waves are originating from a central point. Both at the bottom of her dress and on her arms. The final woman that all these people are connected to with this red dotted heart line, this woman, she's wearing blue overalls. It's got little zigzag patterns on it. It's got a singular pocket on the front. I think what this picture is telling us is that, again, the key to tackling judgment, criticisms, is empathy. Trying to identify with the other person. And it may not always be easy, particularly because, you know, every person is unique. Every person is special in their own way. But trying to see things, trying to understand more about them, you can build, maintain, and improve the relationship. You can make it a happier situation. Alright, that will conclude Breathe Mindfulness for today. I'll be back, I think, tomorrow. Finish out some of those card games. Maybe have Just Chatting Mindfulness again tomorrow. And yeah, I just want to say thank you for watching. Hope you're enjoying the Stormer Show streams. You are, and please feel free to follow. Hope you all have a great weekend and happy Friday. Stormer Show signing out. Stay sheltered, Storm Champions. Okay.